हेलो, टुडे वी विल सी हाउ टू क्रिएट अ क्विज इन मूडल. सो आई हैव लॉग इन टू द मूडल. सो हेयर दिस इज माय डैशबोर्ड. देन क्लिक ऑन साइट होम. सो इन साइट होम यू कैन सी द कोर्सेस यू हैव एनरोल एंड कोर्सेस यू एज अ इंस्ट्रक्टर. सो हेयर For object oriented programming, I am a teacher, I am an instructor, and elective 2, I am a student. So you can create a quiz the course in which you have assigned as an instructor or a teacher. So here I have opened that course by clicking on that. Then here I have to create a quiz. So first you have to click on that setting and click on turn editing. So initially that was off. So like this you will get that setting, and when you click on setting, turn editing on. So when that setting editing is on, you can create a quiz in that. So here already I have created a quiz for you. I will create a new quiz. So for creating any activity or quiz, click on add an activity or resource. Then what we have to create? So we want to create a quiz, so click on that, then click on add. Then you can give name to that quiz, like I give simply OOP quiz. Then you can give description, how many questions, how many marks. Then timing, you can set timer, you can give deadlines. So I have opened this quiz from today and open till, you can enable and you can select that date till end of this month. I have open, after that it will be closed. Then what is the test duration? You can click on enable and you can give test duration 30 minutes. Then after time expire, it will be automatically submit. Then you can give grace period after deadline, again grace period to submit. Then grade for passing, how many marks you want. So out of 10, 4 grade that student must achieve for pass. How many attempts you want to give? So if you have to give unlimited attempt, you can click on here, or if you want to give only one attempt, you can set here. When you give unlimited attempts, highest grade of that attempt that will be stored. Then layout means on one page how many questions. So for every question I have created a web page. Then question behavior. So that is shuffle question, that your question will be shuffled. If you want, if you don't want to shuffle, then you can click on no. Then review option means after submitting that test, what student will get. So I want to display only marks. So I have check only marks. Then later also I want to show only marks and attempt, how many attempt that student has given. And after that quiz is closed, I want to show all the details, what are the correct answers and that. In appearance, you can show if you want to display that student image, then you can set extra restriction and that you can check on your own, that are not important from quiz point of view, and click on save and display. So these are the settings we have set. Again click on edit that quiz to add the questions, then at the right side you will get that message, add a question. So click on new question, or if you have already created a question bank, you can set from that question bank. So here if you want to add a question, There are different types: true, false question, multiple choice, match the following, short answer. So here I have selected multiple choice. Click on add. Then you can give name or serial number. So I have given name as OP here, and you can give question text means what is the question actually. So I write question: when object is created, what is automatically called. Then you can give marks here. By default, one mark is there. I don't want to change. Then you can give here options, constructor. So grade, it is correct answer, so 100%. Then other option, destructor. Third, friend function. And last, method. So like that you can give options. Then click on save changes. Then if you want to shuffle that questions, you can shuffle that. Again, you want to add question, click on add and add new question. So like that we can add questions. If you want to shuffle, we can shuffle that questions and options also. Then click on save. After that, if you want to view that quiz, then click on quiz, then preview, quiz now, start attempt. So same options, same message student will get when he or she start that quiz. So here is the first question. So I give answer, then click on finish attempt. So again it will ask confirm, and in Moodle we will get that time, what is the time left to submit. So if you again want to review that quiz, you can return to attempt, and if you want to submit, click on submit all and finish, again confirm, and you will get the result. So here immediately you will not get that correct answers, how many correct and how many wrong, but you will get only marks. So in this way we can create a quiz in Moodle. So you subscribe my channel, like, share and comment. Thank you very much.